Hi, Jason with Christmas Designers. Today I want to show you how to measure amperage on the electrical cords, the 18-2 C79 light line, zip cord, the different cords that you're using to power up your Christmas lighting and decorating displays. It's important to know the amperage you're drawing so you don't overamp those cords. The other part of that equation is knowing what your maximum amperage for those lines should be. And that's something that's not always understood. We have a separate video that will explain that. It's not just about the gauge of the wire, it's also about the length of the run. So make sure you look at that video as well. Combine your knowledge in that one with this one, you'll be a regular Christmas lighting amperage expert in no time at all. Let's get started. All right, the first tool I want to demonstrate for measuring amperage is going to be a kilowatt meter. This is a simple plug and play meter. You can pick it up online at various places for anywhere from $25 to $35. You simply plug it into your power source, plug in the line that you want to test. You're going to hit the amperage button. And in this case, we're pulling right at about 0.64, 0.65 amps. Very low amperage, no problem on pretty much any standard cord. All right, the next tool I want to demonstrate is going to be a clamp meter. This is used by electricians to take amperage reading at the electrical panel. Now, that's not ideal for our situation. We want to be able to do it at the outlet or at an extension cord, so we need to use a line splitter. Line splitters go for about $15. The clamp meter is anywhere from $35 to $200. You don't need a high-end one. The $35 models will work just fine. The line splitter that can be bought at the store is okay. I do prefer a homemade line splitter. This is what we use. We take a extension cord, short extension cord. We take the insulation off, separate out the hot wire from your neutral and ground, and that hot wire is what you're going to clamp on. Let's go ahead and show you how to use this. We're going to take our line splitter, plug it in to our power source. You have two openings. One is going to be a single, one is 10 times. The 10 times is used whenever you have low power. It's going to multiply by 10 so you get a more accurate reading on your amp meter. We want to do the one times. We're going to select amperage on our meter, clamp it on, and it's going to tell us we're right around 0.6 amps. Very low amperage, no concerns here. To use the homemade line splitter, we're going to do the same thing we did with the store-bought. We're going to plug it into our power source, plug the line we want to test into the line splitter, and then we're going to select amperage, go on the hotline, and we're going to read the amperage, which is right about 0.6, the same thing we got with the store-bought splitter. All right, so it's super easy, as you can see, to take an amp reading on your lines. Very important to understand how to do it, whether you use a simple kilowatt meter, clamp meter. You just want to make sure you're measuring that amperage. And the second part of that that we'll cover in another video is how to know how much amperage your lines can actually hold. That is just as critical as measuring the power going into it. If you haven't found us on the web, visit us at christmasdesigners.com. We do supply professional Christmas installers, but we sell to residential, commercial. We sell to anybody wanting top quality Christmas lights and decorations. Until next time, keep on lighting.